Hello, Mesquite ISD family. Angel Rivera with the board update for the regular meeting held on January the 9th, 2023. So I will tell you, as we celebrated last night, it was Board Recognition Month. And so we recognized the amazing work that our trustees do to support the mission of educating the Mesquite ISD students. So we celebrated the trustees last night. There was a student that gave a speech. I recommend that you go back and watch at least a student's speech. And there were, MEA offered a gift to the board members, and we recognize them, as we know that the work that happens here is not something that occurs in every district in regard to our board of trustees. We also approved the innovative course for LET, for leadership and empowerment for the students. And then we had a couple of appointments doing that. And so I wanted to recognize three appointments that happened last night. The first appointment, Assistant Superintendent of Personnel Services, Dr. Andrea Hensley. Dr. Hensley is coming to us from Cleburne ISD, which currently serves as the Assistant Superintendent of Human Resources for Cleburne. But she's also been an assistant superintendent of curriculum and instruction, a guidance and counseling counselor, has experience in all three levels of education. So we're excited to welcome Dr. Hensley to the Mesquite ISD family. The second appointment we had is Ovidio Tamez. He is gonna be the director of technical services. Mr. Tamez has 12 years of service in the field of education. And he's done a lot of things, webmaster, desktop analyst, help desk technician, and he's also served as a director of information technology. And so we're excited to have Mr. Tamez as our director of technology. We also had an assistant principal for Fraser Middle School, and that is Brianna Calico. And Brianna is completing her 7th year in education, and all in Mesquite ISD. She started her career in Wilkinson, and then she moved away to Fraser, and she served as eighth grade teacher, Algebra 1 teacher, department head, yearbook sponsor, and student success teacher. So she's had a lot of several roles. And so we're excited to welcome Ms. Calico as the assistant principal for Fraser. So we also, tonight, had a report of teaching and learning. And that report showed us everything that we have accomplished and what we're getting ready to do. This presentation was done by Dr. Hammett in terms of as we're getting ready for the STAR redesign and how teaching and learning is getting ready for that. Then Dr. Hammett had a presentation on, Dr. LaDonna Gully did a presentation on leadership and empowerment team and what we've done and the way we're moving. And then we had the action item of paraprofessional or non-professional pay. So tonight, the Mesquite ISD Board of Trustees approved a pay increase for non-professional hourly personnel at a minimum of $15 an hour. Hourly employees already getting at least $15 per hour would also receive a pay increase as a result of tonight's board action. And so employees already earning at least $15 will receive a percentage raise to their current pay rate so that it maintains appropriate step throughout the pay scales. Now, we wanna thank the board for taking action, but we also, I wanted to say that when we were doing the Proposition 1 or Vader campaign, we promised we're gonna increase paraprofessional pay, safety and security upgrades, and paraprofessional to $15 an hour minimum. And so this pay increase was approved by the board on January the 9th, and it will be effective in January. But I'm asking, because we're working, I wanna also thank the payroll and the personnel department because they had to hand calculate all these raises. It'll either go into your first paycheck in February or second paycheck in February. So be a little bit patient as we go here. and I wanted to be clear, due to contract restrictions, Mesquite ISD cannot increase pay for professional employees until the new fiscal year begins in July. But I wanted to say what we promised in the Vader, we're calculating and working through. So in July, those will be effective, but I'm still sticking to my promise that we will have that done before you leave for the year. And then the last thing that the board did was they approved an extension of my contract. So I get the privilege and the pleasure of serving as superintendent of Mesquite for an additional year as it was added to my contract. Those are the updates for tonight. Thank you very much for listening. And as always, we say in Mesquite, excellence always.